want to continue our conversation with two authors, Angela Newsome of Margaret Writes and Robin Walters, whose name might sound familiar. But Angela, I'll begin with you. One of the things that you have proven to me over the course of the years is that you are persistent. And when we talked to Tracy Lydia Garner and when we talked to Jesse Holland earlier, they said they kept at it. I want you to answer the question, which is when you are a best-selling author and everybody says, oh, girl, it was so easy, what are you going to say?
No way. It's never easy. And for me, I strive to be the best and I'm driven. So it'll be ongoing for me. I'll never stop ever with writing and trying to be the best I can at it.
Rob, what about you?
I think people will look at me and say, well, you've always worked with children. You've always taught children in some form or fashion. So that should be something that's easy for you to connect to. The issue is there are so many children's authors out there, so many children's books. So the task is to not make yours, not just yours become a me too, yours to have something that is topical and timely such that it resonates with a parent wanting to buy that book for that child for that particular moment.
Talk to me for a second about being trapped inside a genre. And I want to bring up Elin Harris. Your friend, if you read the book jacket, you will see Robin's name mentioned in there with five of her best friends. And Harris got trapped inside the genre of being the Black gay author. Rob, I know he talked to you about it. What did he say?
He said it wasn't a lifestyle that he chose. It chose him. It wasn't anything. He came into this world, being gay. And he came into this world wanting to write. So the natural tendency was to put the two together. He fought it, you know, but it was the one thing that bought him the quickest amount of fame and money. So he ran with it. And then when he tried to break away from it, it was really difficult. It was the hardest thing that, you know, that he had to do. And I'm not quite sure he lived long enough to see that be successful. But that was something that he struggled with day in and day out.
In fact, he said that his publisher said when he wanted to write a book that wasn't about being gay, go back to the gay thing.
Stay in your lane.
And Angela, what other genres do you want to write about?
Well, anything that's a drama related, thriller, is what I do. It's how I think. But for me, it's not just writing a book. I'm screenwriting right now. So I'm interested in doing other things as well. But mystery and suspense is my favorite genre, and that's probably the best for me. It's hard to think outside of that.
So when you're rich and famous, tell people what it was like when you weren't rich and famous. If you're trying to push a book, what do you have to do? Where do you have to go? And where's the money coming from?
Oh my goodness. It's a lot of footwork involved. You're going to be out there talking to people about your book. You're going to walk in bookstores and as, hey, you know who I am? I'm Margaret Wright. You're going to, any chance you get for the radio or any type of media, you're going to want to do that. Just going where the people are that write, where authors hang out, where your writers are. As I said, I'm looking for both. Screenwriting as well as writing a book. So I'm going to be where they are and I'm going to talk to them about how they did it and how they got to where they are. Because for me, it's not about me making it. It's about me telling others how to do it as well.
And Robin, we should say that our daughter stole a scene from Steel Magnolias in which if you were doing a book signing, she would come up and all of a sudden say, oh my goodness, is that so-and-so? And so she wrote, oh, you got to get your hands on a copy of the book. And it was funny to watch how people would line up to get a copy of the book after she went on about how big of a book this was. But a lot of it is what they call the Bloody Knees Tour, which is you got to get out there and just keep pushing your book.
Absolutely.
Well, she's a very creative marketeer, let's put it that way. So, you know, you've got a concept you want to be marketed. She would be one you would want on your team.
I'm definitely my biggest fan. Anybody that knows me will know I'm my biggest fan.
But you know, the industry is not like it used to be. If you wrote a great book, they find you and they take your book and rework it and get it out there and pay you tons of money to start writing more. That is gone. Right. You know, nowadays, everybody who writes book they have to self-publish. You know, write True. It, illustrate it, go True. Hire it, you know, for some publisher to print it and, you know, and put it out there for you. But it's no longer the other way around.
Angela, we are out of time. I will see you soon. Robin Walters, I will see you at home.
As always, we want to remind you that even during the darkest times, there is something to smile about. In this case, books written by four Black authors who need your help.
Mr. Vice President and Mrs. Gore, and Americans everywhere, a rock, a river, a tree, hosts to species long since departed, marked the mastodon, the dinosaur, who left dry tokens of their sojourn here on our planet floor. Any broad alarm of their hastening doom is lost in the gloom of dust and ages. But today, the rock cries out to us clearly, forcefully. Come, you may stand upon my back and face your distant destiny, but seek no haven in my shadow. I will give you no hiding place down here. Lift up your faces. You have a piercing need for this bright morning dawning for you. History, despite its wrenching pain, cannot be unlived, but if faced with courage, need not be lived again. Lift up your eyes upon this day breaking for you. Give birth again to the dream. Women, children, men, take it into the palms of your hands. Mold it into the shape of your most private needs. Sculpt it into the image of your most public self. Lift up your heart. Each new hour holds new chances for new beginnings. Do not be wedded forever to fear, yoked eternally to brutishness. The horizon leans forward, offering you space to place new steps of change. Here, on the pulse of this fine day, you may have the courage to look up and out and upon me, the rock, the river, the trees, your country. No less to Midas than the mendicant, no less to you now than the mastodon then. Here, on the pulse of this new day, you may have the grace to look up and out and into your sister's eyes and into your brother's face, your country, and say simply, very simply, with hope, good morning.